get out of space, you might want to call my next guest, actress Gates McFadden, because she plays Dr. Beverly Crusher on the hit series Star Trek, The Next Generation. Let's take a look for a second.
I won't forget. I won't forget any of you.
She's choreographed David Bowie in The Mad Hatter, and she can also ride a unicycle. Will you please welcome Gates McFadden? Pretty shoes.
Aren't they beautiful?
They were lent by our
a member of the crew. I don't know why I'm giving them to you. I'm sorry, but it's not a nice gift.
Oh,
we don't recommend this for hygiene, I don't think.
No. That's how did you learn, or why did you learn to ride a unicycle?
Well, actually, I think that the unicycle is harder than the vortex, which was the clip you just saw. It was strange. I grew up in Ohio, and I went to a dancing school, the local dancing school. And one of my teachers, this was outside of Akron in Cleveland, she had been in a circus, so we learned to walk on these giant wooden balls that they later did in No No Nanette, you know.
Right.
They used to do it, I guess, years ago. I'm out of breath on the unicycle. And so they also taught us to do the unicycles. We'd do these big kick lines. I was a member of the kick line. But I was ahead in school, and I was really the ugly duckling. I had huge hands and huge feet, which I still have. But now I'm a little taller
right.
as well.
So you grew into it.
I grew into it. And most of the other girls, I went to this prep school, private school. Everyone was into horses, and I was, you know, the scholarship student there. But I loved the dance studio. That's where I loved hanging out. And I particularly loved this one woman who I looked up to. She had this wonderful bleach blonde hair and sometimes wore it in a beehive. Her name was LaDonna. And she was cool, and I really loved her. And she knew how to do this, and so she would help me. And then when all my friends were out dating, I would be down at the dance studio bruising my leg. It's actually really hard to
hard to do that.
I haven't done it for like 20 years. It's amazing I even got through this.
But you know, if you could do that around, that would be great aerobics for you.
Yeah, I think so.
Yeah. I wouldn't suggest, well, it'd be good for a New York apartment, you know, because you can just like go in little circles. You went to a very full prep school, and yet you were doing kick dancing.
It was odd.
Odd isn't the word. How'd you get in a kick line? I mean, it was very young.
Well, yeah, I started dancing, though, when I was about 2.5 or 3. I mean, I don't think we call it dance. I think we just call it curtsying or,
right.
you know, that sort of thing. But I loved it so much, and I did, I really just loved performing, I guess. And so there was this group of us who had agents, and I used to fake my age, falsies in the costume, sequin costumes, you know, the mesh stockings.
Right.
And on the weekends, I'd go to... Well, actually, I did it when I was a kid on I think, like, the local television shows and things like that, you know. And I'd play the Elks Club and the Moose Club. And then we'd go to, like, Oil City, Pennsylvania or Erie, Pennsylvania. My mother would drive me. So she loved, you know, everyone...
She was stage mom, but yeah.
Well, yeah, she sort of liked the fact that everyone, I think, thought she was my sister.
Yeah.
And I had a gas. I would sing a song and do a tap dance, or else we'd do it, a group of us. Some of my friends later went on to be Rockettes, actually.
Are they still?
I don't know. I mean, we haven't, you know, kept in touch. I went off to college, and I was getting more esoteric in my theater.
And very smart, I heard.
Well,
you're a very, very smart student. Very smart.
My mother told you that, right?
No. You're press agent. Ask her anything.
Right.
How did you get on Star Trek? Star Trek, the second generation.
The next generation.